here's the opening kickoff for today's game. And we're underway here for the second game of the 2017 season. And he's down around the 25-yard line. Here comes Tanner Westwood out for the beginning of the game. He's the starter today. He had 246 yards last week, but unfortunately they lost by a couple of points late in the game. And the snap is underway, and he's gonna run it, and he's down around the 26-yard line.
Last week against Lake Park, they really struggled against the run. Let's see if they can get it going again today. Need Ashford with the carry for about a yard.
Last week, Bryce Logan, he had a pretty good game.
Yeah, he did. He scored two touchdowns and was really good on special teams.
And he's only a sophomore. And, oh, he's going at the 40. Oh, and he's down around the 44-yard line.
Chuck Robinson was really quiet last game aside from his interception on the first play on defense. Really hoping to make some noise in this game, really being really important on the receiving end of the ball. Really going to be interesting, Ryan, to see how the receivers can handle stepping up without Eric Gesh, who's out for about 2 weeks with an injury now.
Yeah. But hopefully he'll be back at it a couple weeks. Oh, and he's running it, and he's going. Oh, to the 50, to the 40. And he's down around the 30-yard line.
Nate Ashford gets to open field. That's going to be a tough tackle to make. He's really fast.
And here's Tanner Westwood in the pocket. Oh, and he's handing it off. Oh, and a beautiful, the 30, the 20. Touchdown, Warriors.
Bryce Logan.
What a great touchdown by Bryce Logan.
Bryce Logan's making an immediate impact already. Third touchdown of the season. That was about a 25-yard run. Really great play from him.
The crowd over there, they're looking really excited right now.
Yeah, absolutely. I think they're getting excited because the run game's already looking good.
Yeah.
They got two big carries from their two main backs. You're going to see a lot of two-back sets today, especially with Bryce Logan and Nate Ashford. Really going to be confusing for the defense to which one they're going to go to because they're both extremely dangerous.
And the kick is up, and it's good. The Warriors lead 7-0 against the Glenbrook North Panthers. And we'll be back after our break. And we're back here at Dick Kerner Stadium for the kickoff after that great drive.
Yeah, really important for them to score on the opening drive, get them some points really early. Yeah, last week against Lake Park, it took their offense a little bit of time to get going, but now it seems like they're off and ready to go.
That kick is off. Oh, my God. Oh, he's going the 40. And he's down around the 45-yard line.
Tyreek Henderson with a big return. That's going to be huge for the ground game for Glenbard North to get started, especially after answering after an opening drive score.
And he hands it off. Oh, and he's going. And he's down around the 50-yard line. He didn't quite get the first down there. And he's down. That was a pretty good run there, I would say.
Yeah, absolutely. Got right up the middle, really tearing apart the Waubonsie run defense right now. Really seeing how they can respond. Got a two-back set.
And Randy Lee is here in the pocket. And he hands it off. Oh, and a great tackle by the Warriors defense. It was a great play there.
Absolutely, huge tackle in the backfield. Had a couple big gains, but that's a huge stopper right there. They lost about 3 yards.
And he hands it off again. Oh, and he's going nowhere. What a great tackle.
Run defense showing up huge for Waubonsie. Going to be third and 15 now. Let's see what North plans on doing. Maybe you see a draw play here.
Oh, and there was a switch on the play, 25 and 6. Switched it out on that play. Oh. Oh! Was he in? He was not in. That is an incomplete pass.
Cornerback just pushed him out at the last second. Huge play. That'll bring up 4th and 16, and it looks like Glenbourne North is going to be forced to punt.
The punting unit coming out.
Waubonsie got two fake punts against them last week, both going for first down. Hopefully, they can get that all sorted out tonight.
And he kicks it off. Punts it, excuse me. And it's out of bounds.
Great punt for Glenbard North. Looks like they're marking it out at about the 3. That's going to be tough field positioning for Waubonsie. Glenbard's defense is going to see if they can steal a safety right here.
I mean, this Warriors D, they had a great first drive. I mean, that was a great drive.
Absolutely. They got to the running back, and their corners played tight on the wide receivers.
And here comes Tanner Westwood and the Warriors offense. And he hands it off to Logan. Oh, and he's down. Not a lot of gain there.
No, not at all.
Both these here are pretty good.
Run defense is going to be huge for both these teams. They both seem to be very heavy run offenses. It seems like whoever does the best at run defense is probably going to have the best shot at winning the game.
Absolutely. And they're in the huddle. Okay, and they're on the line. Oh, and a fake handoff. Oh, and he's down.
Chuck Robinson with two big catches today, two first downs, already making arguably a bigger impact than he did last week. Seems like last week Lake Park was shutting him down in all facets of the game where he could only really make an impact on defense with that interception. But today he's already making big gains.
Hopefully Chuck Robinson will have a good game today. Last game it was a little rough with the drop passes, but I think he could get back in this game and be successful. And a run. Oh, no. He faked everyone out, but it did not work out.
This Waubonsie offense relies heavily on the run. If it's from Bryce Logan, Nate Ashford, or Tanner Westwood, all three of them are very dangerous on the ground. So Glenbard North's going to have to watch them all very carefully.
There's about 5:56 left in the first quarter. He throws it. There goes Robinson. Down. He's to the 30-yard line. What a great play.
Absolutely. Chuck Robinson's a threat with yards after the catch. Just a big body, really hard to bring down.
And the snap is off. He's waiting for someone. Oh, and what a great catch by Chuck Robinson. He's already having a better game than last week.
Absolutely. He's already at four catches for about 50 yards. I think Waubonsie's trying to work extra hard to get the balls into his hands today. Probably lacking a little bit from last week, and they figured out, you know what, we need to get this guy the ball.
On the line for another time. Tanner Westwood there in the pocket, and he gets it. Oh, and he's going to run it himself, but he only gains about 5 yards. He almost fumbled it there, but luckily he had the ball. A little chilly out here, but the fans still seem to be enjoying it.
You have to wonder if that affects the players, too, in their hands. Ball's going to be a little lighter today, so. Got to watch for them turnovers.
Oh, he's going to run on himself. I don't know if he got the first down or not. He might be a little short. We're not sure. We're going to wait for the call.
They're moving the chains.
And that's a first down. What a great run there. I mean, this running offense is pretty good.
Yards after first touch is really good for them, too. It seems like they've been breaking tackles really fast this game.
And there's an offside play. There's going to be a penalty on the play. A little bit of a false start there.
Absolutely. Tanner Westwood probably got him with a hard count. First and five. Let's see what they do here. Probably expecting a run. Maybe you want to see a pass here.
And the crowd chanting, you can't do that. Oh, and there's going to be a flag.
It looks like they're just going to lose that yardage right back over here. It looks like it's going to be a false start on someone on the offensive line.
They didn't get the play off in time. It's a tough penalty, you know.
Especially on first and five, you think you have a little yardage to get for that next first down, but you're back to first and 10, and you're back to square one.
And the snap is off. And Tanner looking, oh, and it's incomplete.
Incomplete, great dive for the catch though. Great effort from Julian Kane. Looks like he could be one influential player that's stepping up for Eric Esch in his absence. See a lot of Glenbard North players with hands on their hips. Think this Waubonsie high tempo offense is getting to them.
Oh, and he's down at the 40. That's going to bring up third down and eight. Tanner Westwood talking to the coach over there, getting the plays. Backfield, and he throws it, and it's complete. What a great grab.
Great over the shoulder catch by Bryce Logan, one of the toughest catches to make in football, and he gets the first down. Huge play. They're now in field goal position as well. Really a huge drive here. If the Warriors could go up by two scores, really get ahead of this Glenbard North team, make it really hard for them to get back in the game.
And he hands it off. And he's down.
Glenbard North's run defense has been really consistent today. Really getting to Bryce Logan really early at the line. That's key for their defense to keep continuing success.
And the snap is off. Oh, and he faked. Oh, and it's an incomplete pass. Chuck Robinson, he just came up short to catching the ball.
Yeah, he's going to want that one back, but I doubt you see that mistake more than once or twice in one game. Chuck Robinson actually recently just committed to NIU for football.
Tanner Westwood with the ball. Oh, and he fakes everyone out, and he gives it to Bryce Logan for the first down. Bryce Logan's been having an incredible game already. Hopefully he'll have just as good of a game as last week. Last week he had two touchdowns, which was pretty good.
Absolutely, Ryan. He's dangerous on all facets of the field. Running back, catching the ball out of the backfield, and also special teams.
ties in. Tanner Westwood for the touchdown to give the Warriors a 13-0 lead.
Great juke move by Tanner Westwood. Looks like he could be in some trouble, but made one slick move and he was open field all the way. Tanner Westwood's first touchdown run of the year for 9 yards.
And it's up through the... And the Warriors lead 14-0, and we'll be back right after this break.
And we're back from our break. Cross Holmes about to kick off the ball for Wabonzi. Tyreek Henderson back, returning for Glenbard North. Josh Flowers also back there.
And the kick is underway. And he's down at the 20-yard line.
Tyreek Henderson tackled by number 25, Brennan Guido.
He had an interception last week against the Lake Park Lancers.
Yep, there was a lot of turnovers in that game.
Yeah. First and 10 Panthers at the 20-yard line. Lee Ray back in the backfield, and he gives it. Oh, and he tried to make a move, but he fortunately did not work, so he's down at the 30-yard line.
Nice little wide receiver screen to Josh Flowers, gets the first down. Oh, they're marking him just a bit short.
And he gives it, he pitches it, and he's down about the 35-yard line. I think they should go for a little bit of a deeper pass because this short.
Yeah, these short runs aren't helping him out at all. Michael Mullman with the carry does pick up 5 yards, though. That will move the chains. Kyle Schrader with the tackle.
Almost offsides, and he's down. And he's not gonna get the first down, not even close.
Michael Wellman surrounded by about five Warriors at the 35-yard line. And that'll be the end of the first quarter. We'll take a quick break and we'll be right back.
The following 17-18 sponsors, Corn Decor, Buffalo Wings. Nation Tech, Planet Fitness, Bartels Auto Clinic, McAllister's Deli, Tide Cleaners, Raising Cane's. We thank them for their support. Be sure to support the Boosters at halftime, going to the concession stands, checking out the Royal Royal.
And we're back from our break.
And there's a flag. There's a false start on the play.
It actually might be an offsides on the Warriors. Looks like number 47, Alaya Rivalovos, jumped. Second and five on the 41.
Oh, and there's a fumble, but it does not count.
There's a flag on the play as well. Be interesting to see what they call here. Did you see anything, Ryan?
I don't really know what I didn't see a flag on the play. Not that I saw, but there's a false start penalty on the offense, which will bring them back 5 yards.
Second and 10 moves them back to the 36, kind of like what happened to the Warriors in the first quarter. Terry Quinton in the backfield.
And Lee Rady hands it off there on that play. He almost went outside. Randy Ray. Excuse me, Lee Randy.
Tyreek Henderson with the catch picks up the first down. That'll move the chains. Glenbard North's offense not moving as fast as Waubonsie's. Seemed to be slowing down the play a little bit. That's going to allow Waubonsie's defense to catch their breath. Maybe you'll see them pick it up here in a couple minutes.
And he hands it off, and he's down.
Quinton Terry with about a 2 yard gain. You got about five Warriors that wrapped him up, bringing him down.
That's going to be a second and eight on the play.
I believe Kyle Schrader's the first one to get to him.
And Lee ready to snap it, and he pitches it, and he's down around the 45-yard line.
Nice little run by Terry Quinton. A couple yards after the first touch. Quinton Terry in the backfield, two back set. Two wide receivers split outside.
And he hands it off. And he's not going to get the first down. That's going to bring fourth down up. And the punting unit will be coming out to punt.
There is a flag on the play. We'll await the call. Where's defense still on the field?
We don't know what the call is. And it looks like they're going to go for it here on fourth and three. Warriors defense needs to pick it up here to stop them. But we'll see what happens.
This is back-to-back games where teams have not been afraid to go on it for it on this Warriors defense.
And there's whistles.
Timeout called by the Warriors. Looks like Coach Murphy's going to be drawing up a play preparing for this. Maybe Glenbarton North tries to draw him off sides, pick up that first down without ever having to snap the ball. It'll be interesting to see what Glenbarton North tries to do here, Ryan. You think they're going to run it or pass it?
I mean, I don't know. They've been really excited about running it today. So maybe I think they're going to fake the offense off and go a fake run and throw it down the field and get a first down.
Yeah, I'd have to agree with you. I almost believe they have to go with the pass. They haven't really been able to get that long of runs off on this Waubonsie defense. The longest run's about been for 5 or 6 yards. Probably going to see a pass play. I can totally see what you mean with a play action fake, though.
There's 8:54 left in the second quarter. And there's the marching Warriors over there.
I formation for Glenbarton North.
And Lee Rady. Oh, and he throws it.
He's going deep.
He's going deep. Oh, and it's incomplete pass.
Incomplete. It'll be interesting to see who is on the coverage.
What a great play by the Warriors for knocking that ball down.
Looks like Brandon Guido on the coverage. Great man-on-man play right there. Looks like we called that play right from the start. They went with the play action, tried to throw the deep ball. Sadly, they threw it into double coverage, though. Wide receiver didn't have much of a chance to catch that. Ball was a little bit underthrown.
And now it'll be a turnover, and the Warriors will be on offense.
Good field position to start out here. What do you say, Ryan?
Yeah, I say they've been playing really good today. Hopefully they can keep it up.
Let's see if this Glenbarton North defense answers with anything. They haven't been able to stop the run that well.
And Tanner Westwood with it. Oh, and Bryce Holt, what a great block by Bryce Logan there. That was a great job over there.
Also a great pump fake by Tanner Westwood, one of the most underrated plays in football. If you can sell it, you have the defense looking the wrong way, you can find open receivers. Also great coverage by Glenbarton North's defense.
Tanner Rushwood in the backfield.
Two back set.
And he hands it off to Bryce Logan. Go to the 50, the 40, and he's down around the
45. Nate Ashford actually with the carry correction on that. They almost had me faked out there too. Bryce Logan and Nate Ashford are so dangerous in the backfield that defense has to commit to at least one and then make a decision. Sadly, they're guessing right now, and that was a huge carry by Nate Ashford for about 15-yard pickup. Another two-back set.
And there's Tanner Westwood. And Westwood handed it off to Bryce Logan for a gain of a couple of yards.
Warriors have been running the ball quite a bit today. Even when they're throwing it, though, the offensive line has been giving Tanner Westwood a ton of time in the pocket.
And Westwood with the ball, and he hands it off to Nate Efron.
Tackle made by Michael Wellman for Glenbard North. Nate Ashford with another solid run.
And there's Tanner Westwood out there again.
Another two-back set.
They keep the defense guessing who they're going to hand it off to. Not that time, though. They might.
Looks like they ran it to Nate Ashford once again. Honestly, Warriors have us guessing, but Glenbard North's defense read that like a book. Looks like they're picking up on the Warriors' offense a little bit here. Wonder if they're going to start throwing the ball.
Yeah, we'll see right here.
Looks like on fourth and two they're going for it. Ryan, what do you expect here?
I mean, they are in the 30-yard line, so it's not that big of a risk if they don't get it.
Right. Just a little bit out of field goal position, too.
And there's going to be a timeout by Glenbard North Panthers.
Panthers look like they're trying to figure out how to stop this run by the Warriors. I think this would be a good time for them to run a play-action play as well, find Chuck Robinson maybe open in the end zone. I think this year, with Tanner Westwood being a senior, they're trusting his arm a lot more, and he's been making the accurate passes this game, so I would definitely see what they can do to stretch the field.
And it's ESPN night here for the fans.
ESPN game day with all the funny signs.
Thanks, Dan.
Another two-back set for the Warriors. We have fourth and two.
Westwood waiting for the snap.
Looks like he's making an audible.
Oh, and that's going to be good enough for a first down.
That's going to
be the chains. Westwood with that great run there.
Great run. Absolutely right, Ryan. Just fought forward to get that first down. Really well-designed play by Coach Murphy. One back set here for the Warriors that's been rare to see today. Chuck Robinson in motion.
So close. What a great diving opportunity, though. What a great effort there.
Correction on that. Nate Ashford in motion. And Ashford coming up slow, possibly injured. Would have been an outstanding catch by Ashford. One of the few times the Warriors are trying to throw the ball today.
Westwood, he's going to run it himself again. He's only going to gain about 1 yard if he's lucky.
Yeah, well, Bonzi really trying to keep Glenbard North guessing, but Glenbard North is picking up on the runs very well, not biting on them. Tanner Westwood is a threat with his feet. Glenbard North recognizes that, and they've been picking him up very well.
Here comes Westwood in the huddle.
two-back set with Nate Ashford and Bryce Logan.
And the snap is off. Oh, and he faked that one out, thinking it was going to Bryce. And he catches it, and it's a touchdown, Warriors! Touchdown!
Harper Cole with another touchdown in back-to-back games. Another outstanding catch. Seems like both times he's been found wide open is when they're on play-action passes. Warriors take a 20-0 lead. What do you think of that play, Ryan?
I thought it was a great opportunity, great catch, and what a great throw, and the effort was just incredible there.
Right on the money, great catch, great throw by Tanner Westwood, and another great play call by Coach Paul Murphy.
And it's good. The Warriors lead the Glenbrook North Panthers 21-0. And we will be right back after the break.
And we're back from our break. Cross Holmes about to kick it off to Glenbard North. Once again, Tyreek Henderson and Josh Flowers returning.
Is underway.
Tyreek Henderson picks it up.
And he's down around the 27 yard line.
Another decent return for Glenbard North. Be interesting to see how Glenbard North responds to this 21-0 deficit. Got 5 minutes left in the half. Hopefully they can put a score on the board, make the game a little bit more interesting. Michael Oswald in the backfield.
Hands it off. What a great truck there, I mean. That was a great move.
Kyle Schrader and Carson O'Donnell with the tackle.
And he pitches it, and he's going. Oh, and that's going to be good enough for Glenbrook North. First down.
That'll move the chains. They take Michael Oswald out of the game. Kind of surprising. He had two really solid runs there, picked up the first down. He is rostered as a fullback, though, so probably that's the probability why.
He's going to run it right up the middle. And that's going to be good for another Glenbrook North first down.
Kavion Reddick with the tackle. Best run of the day for Glenbrook North. Quinton Terry with the run. Picks up a big chunk of yardage for Glenbrook North. Finally in Wabonzi's side of the field. Let's see if they can score on this drive.
And I'd like to say thank you for all our fans watching the game tonight. Thank you. It's a handoff in the Warriors. Put him down.
Quinton Terry wrapped up in the backfield. Kyle Schrader, first man to get to him. Took a couple more guys to get him down, but loss of two right there. Big play for the Warriors. Quinton Terry in the backfield. Lee Rady.
Oh, and he fakes everyone out. And he throws it. And a great catch. It's going to be about 5 yards short of the first down. But a great play there.
Yeah, absolutely. Josh Flowers with the catch. He's been huge on offense for Glenbard North. Glenbard North's been going to him a lot when they've been throwing the ball. Looks like they're not trying to get many other receivers involved in this game. Let's see if they can eventually do that.
Yeah. We'll see what they do here on the next play.
Not quite in field goal range yet. Quinton Terry in the backfield. Lee Rady under center. Little bobble there by Quinton Terry. Looks like Brandon Guido got to him first. We're going to get about a loss of 8 or so on the play.
And that's going to pull up fourth down here for the Glenbard North Panthers.
Glenbard North really got something going on that drive. It's a shame to see it end on a fumble. But Warriors about to get the ball back with 2 minutes left, and now we get to see them run a two-minute drill.
They're both huddling up. We're not sure if Glenbard North is going to go for it here or if they're going to punt, but we'll see.
Maybe you see a fake punt here. Lake Park tried that 2 times last week and both ended up being successful. I think the Warriors are prepared for that now. I don't think they want to let any of those fly anymore.
And it looks like the offense is coming out.
Really a risky play with 14 yards to the first down. Maybe they just take a shot at the end zone and try and put points on the board before half.
Oh, and he throws it. And it's caught.
Wow.
Down at the 30-yard line. What an athletic play.
Big play by Josh Flowers again. Making the huge catch. Gets the drive to keep going. Kind of surprised they didn't punt there, but you know what? It was a risky play and it paid off. Now they're well within field goal range as well, and if they need to put points on the board before the half, they are well capable of it.
And it's a handoff, and he's going to gain some yardage on the play.
Michael Oswald with the carry gains about 2 yards. Nothing much there. Another big play by the Warriors defense.
I think they should do another throwing play. I mean, that worked really good last time around.
Yeah, absolutely. And I think the Warriors knew they were going to throw it. You're not going to run a draw play on 4th and 14. So the Warriors picked up the throwing, but Josh Flowers found open field, and Lee Rady made an outstanding throw. Looks like there's another timeout on the field.
There's a timeout on the play. And we'll be right back after this.
And we're back. And the Warriors defense takes the field.
And a shout out to Adam Moody watching the game from Michigan. Big Warriors fan.
Lee Rady about ready to take the snap.
Oh!
Chuck Robinson misses the tackle. Still an incomplete pass. Big play for the Warriors, but it would have been a nice loss of yardage if Chuck Robinson made the tackle. Chuck Robinson, a huge playmaker on offense and defense. Really would have been huge if he made that tackle there to keep the clock running and make Glenbard North keep the clock running, because they are out of timeouts. They have no timeouts left. Third and eight, huge play here in the first half. Glenbard North trying to put points on the board. Low snap.
Oh, and it's incomplete.
Lee Rady just underthrows his wide receiver, Tyreek Henderson. Josh Flowers. Fourth down. Do you think they go for it again, Ryan?
You know, I don't know. That's a tough question here. But, you know, they got to get some points on the board, so I say you go for it. And there's only 1 minute and 13 seconds left.
You don't kick the field goal here?
I think they need more points than a field goal.
I'd have to agree with you.
Yeah.
Looks like the offense is staying on the field as well. Fourth and eight. Lee Rady gets the snap.
He throws it, and it's picked off! He's going the 30, the 40, the 50. Can he go all the... No, he cannot, but it's a good try.
Yeah, absolutely. Derek Lee picks it off at about the 10, gets it all the way down to the 5. Derek Lee was injured most of last year wearing an arm brace when he plays. Oh, it looks like there's a flag on the play. Back to what I was saying, though, Derek Lee with a huge interception. Wasn't able to make any last year quite because of his arm brace. But this year gets his first interception of the year, and it's a big play for the Warriors to keep points off the board. Looks like there's a flag on the play, maybe for an illegal block in the back, or maybe over-celebration. I don't know. We'll have to find out. Correction, Brandon Guido with the interception. I was correct, there was an illegal block in the back penalty. That will move the Warriors back just a little bit.
It's illegal.
Big interception for the Warriors.
First and 10, the Warriors at the 28-yard line.
Another two back set for the Warriors. Nate Ashford to the left, Bryce Logan to the right.
And there's Westwood there. He's handing it off to Bryce Logan for a gain about a couple of yards. And we'll be back right after this.
Hey, Warrior fans, be sure to sign up for this year's Warriors on the Run 5K. You can register for this event on the booster page, wvhsboosters.org. The race will take place on Sunday, October 1st, beginning at 10 a.m. Join us for a party of colorful proportions. Get as much or as little color as you want while trekking around beautiful Wabanji Lake on the WVHS campus. Run it fast, run it slow, skip, dance, or walk the course. Funky costumes and sailing wigs, of course.
same race guide to find out more about the Color 5K, Color Throw Party, raffle prizes, map, and more.
And we're back as the Warriors take the field, getting ready to try and put some points on the board before half ends. 21-0 Warriors, 2nd and 2.
And Westwood getting some pressure, but he throws it. Oh, and it's incomplete. Oh, but there's a flag on the play.
A little bit of a late flag, but I think it was a good call, and it's the right call. I believe that was Harper Cole that was an intended receiver, and he was interfered with before he could get the ball. So I absolutely think that was the right call on the field. The question is, did they call pass interference or holding?
And it's going to be a first and goal for the Warriors.
Looks like they just called holding. Pass interference would have moved them farther up, more towards the goal line. Another two-back set. You're going to see that a lot with the Warriors.
And Westwood with the snap. And, oh no, he doesn't. He's going to run it.
Another run for Tanner Westwood.
And that's going to bring up 2nd and goal. But that was a great effort. Hopefully in the next play he could get in.
Clock still running. You're down to 25 seconds left in the half. They've been running Chuck Robinson in motion a lot. They're down to 20 seconds in the half. Maybe looking for a spike here, or are they just going to run it?
Westwood throwing it. Oh, and it's incomplete. Off the fingertips of Bryce Logan.
Jabari Fitzpatrick with the coverage. Great D right there. 9.6 seconds left in the half.
We'll see what they do here. And they call a timeout.
What do you expect, Ryan? I'm expecting a throw to Chuck Robinson here. When you've got a tight end or wide receiver with his frame, you just throw it up to him and hope he comes down with it. Because a 50-50 ball for him is more like a 90-10% chance.
Yeah, I say you go in the corner end zone just so it doesn't get picked off. And if they catch it, it's a touchdown. But if they don't, they could go for 3.
I think even if it does get picked off, they're not too worried about it. Because
yeah.
I can't really see a cornerback turning up the field with that, especially in the corner of the end zone. So I totally agree with you. I think that's exactly what they should do. Maybe expecting a back shoulder throw to Chuck Robinson.
And there's the fans. ESPN game day night.
You see the fans all wearing their favorite jerseys. Basketball, football, baseball, hockey, it does not matter. Any jersey counts. It's that theme as well for Glenbard North. They're rocking all their jerseys as well. Glenbard North's defense takes the field. So does Waubonsie's offense. Probably looking at the last play of the half if Waubonsie does not score. Bryce Logan to the left of Tanner Westwood.
Westwood with a snap. Oh, he's under pressure to Bryce Logan. He's going, and he's not going to get it. They better call a timeout here.
They're out of timeouts.
Are they gonna? And that's the end of the half. And we'll be back for the second half in about 15 minutes.
Warriors lead 21-0. For WTV, I'm Dane Dreyfus.
And I'm Ryan Carlin.
We'll be right back.
Ladies and gentlemen, please direct your attention to the field for the varsity dance. will be performing a portion of the competition show, Dark Matter. The concept of our show delves into the theory that our universe is made up primarily of dark matter, such as collapsed stars and black holes. The woodwind, brass music is arranged by Indian current Andrew Schneider, and professional music is written by Phil Beale. The flat floor work is designed by Chuck Cummings, Lisa Savage, and Billy Steiner. The show's concept portrays elements of our universe such as primordial plasma, velocity, dispersion, gravitational lensing, and the annihilation of stars. Tonight we are going to take through the show as the band plays the first time. Mr. Carroll would like to thank the fantastic band booster organization for all their efforts in help making the Marching Warriors look great on and off the field. Our next performance, we will see them wearing a premium in the band match a brand new uniform. Thank you to the amazing Marching Warriors staff, Phil Beale, Kevin Carroll, Chuck Cummings, Chris Sandelis, Mark Duker, Donald DeVore, Lisa Savage, Justin Sanders, and Billy Steiner. The Marching Warriors are led by drum majors Jessica Houghton, Matthew Packerbill, Jacob Trechenberg, and Danny Wilczynski. Drum majors, is your band ready? We have the field for performance. Thank you.
And we're back from half. I'm Dane Dreyfus.
And I'm Ryan Carlin.
And we're getting ready to kick off the second half.
And here's the kick to start the second half off.
Cross Holmes kicking.
And the kick is off and a little low. There he goes. He's going to the 40, to the 50, and he's down.
Thrown down furiously by Kyle Schrader. Tyreek Henderson with a big return. Already in Warrior territory. That's a huge play for Glenbard North to start off the second half. Quinton Terry in the backfield for Glenbard North. About ready to take the snap.
And there's a flag on the play.
Looks like a false start on the offense.
And they're in a huddle right now. Let's see what they're doing.
Once again,
and Lee Rady hands it off, and he's down, only gonna gain about a couple of yards there on the play.
Quinton Terry with the carry. Hasn't been able to pick up much on the ground game. Let's see if Glenbard North starts to use the air a little bit out here.
And that's going to be second and 15 on the 43-yard line. Rady in the back. Rady hands it off to Flowers. He's got beautiful flowers.
Well, the beautiful flowers does not pick up that many yards on the jet sweep there. Trying to use some trick plays on the Warriors doesn't really get them anywhere. They're down to their third down. And let's see how they respond. They got to throw it here, I'd have to believe. Right, Ryan?
Right, I agree on that call. He's running it, and he's down at the 40-yard line.
Lee Rady with the wheels there really started to pick up speed.
And Rady, he's a pretty good runner here.
Yeah, he is. He actually picked up speed there. I actually got a little scared, but Eric France seemed to trip him up, and then Kyle Schrader finished off the tackle. Fourth and four, the offense is still on the field. Are you surprised by this, Ryan?
Yeah, I'm a little surprised.
Seems a little early in the half to be going for it on
fourth down. Yeah, I mean, but they are down by 21, so they got to just do whatever they can to win.
Warriors blitzing.
And he gives it.
Tyreek Henderson going nowhere.
Nowhere. And he's down. A little bit of a loss of yards, and they're not going to be able to get the fourth down. Warriors will get the ball back.
Good field positioning for him, too.
Yeah, I mean, it was pretty good, but they just couldn't get it. Oh, wait. They got the first down. My apologies. Wait, they did not get it. The Warriors ball. Sorry about that, fans.
Two back set again for the Warriors. Warriors pulling it away with the game a little bit here.
Oh, and he's down.
Tanner Westwood probably has about 7 carries for about 15 yards. These quarterback draws aren't doing much for him. He does have a 10-yard carry for a touchdown, though, so that's about as much as they've gotten with the ground game with Tanner today. Wonder if they'll just start running the ball or airing it out a little bit. You wonder if Chuck Robinson will be getting the ball any more this game. Chuck has been quiet since the first quarter.
And here's Westwood in the pocket. He throws it, and Chuck with the catch. Oh, but he gets crushed by 5 players.
Looks like Prince Goodlow with the tackle there. Ferocious on Chuck Robinson. It's funny, I say Chuck Robinson's been quiet, and then he goes ahead and catches the ball right in front of my face.
Third down and 10 here. Let's see what Westwood can do here. Can he get the first down or no? We'll find out. But he hands it off. And he's going nowhere. I mean, I don't know why he would hand it off on third and 10, but they did, and they'll try next time.
Yeah, they will.
Yeah.
Nate Ashford with the run got wrapped up there. It looks like Ricardo Thompson got to him first. Warriors looking like they're about to punt.
The punting unit out there.
And Josh Flowers out to return.
And the punt is underway. And
short hops, takes a good bounce for the Warriors.
Ooh, what a hit. And it's a touchdown, Wart. Aw.
They're waving him down at the one.
That's not a touchdown, but we'll see what will happen here.
Good play. Josh Flowers did get popped there. Sadly, didn't get to see who got to him first. My apologies, but still a great play by Warriors special teams. You know, Warriors special teams the past 2 games have been awesome. They've been making huge plays for the offense. And now Tanner Westwood, Bryce Logan, and Nate Ashford get wonderful field position. I guarantee you they'll stuff it home on the run somehow.
I mean, they got a great defense here. They're just playing incredible here. I mean, that was a great knock out of the hand, but yeah.
Got a feel for the senior, Josh Flowers. Kind of a critical mistake there. Almost kind of just want to try and let that roll out of bounds or maybe even roll into the end zone. But sadly, he picks up the ball, gets popped, and sadly comes out of his hands. And that would be known as a muffed punt. So
I mean, he got
even us in the booth went, whoa, after
we were
seeing
like,
that
wow,
one.
Wow, holy crap. And the defense out on the field.
Refs having a conversation about something over here. Looks like there might have been a flag on the play that they picked up. Tyreek Henderson talking to the refs, it seems like, too. Maybe there was a signal for a fair catch we didn't see?
Yeah. I don't know, but that was a great try.
Absolutely.
Oh, and they're going to move the chains. They're moving it.
What's going on here?
We don't know what the call is. Huh. He's really taking them far back. And they're down on the 40 now.
What happened here?
Huh.
As you can see, folks, me and Ryan are probably just as confused as you right now. Looks like the refs are having a conversation with Zach Lyons, and
we don't know what the call was on.
You know what? I believe it is an offsides on the punting team. So they will redo this.
Ah.
It was either a false start or offsides. Warriors seem to be very frustrated with this call right now. A little bit of a saving grace for Glenbard North. They really need to put some points on the board. Panthers have been struggling to get the ball down the field, and they haven't, I believe they've only gotten in the red zone once or twice today.
And so punt again for the second time.
Mark this play down.
Penalty on the play.
Mark this play down, Ryan, because this could be huge for the game if Glenbard North can get on the board.
And
it's a low snap.
It's a low snap, and the punter, and he's sacked. I'm tackled. That was a great play by Glenbard North. Panthers, great defensive play, and we'll see.
That's back-to-back games where Cross Holmes has gotten a low snap on a punt and sadly couldn't punt it off. Let's see if Glenbard North can cash in on this now. Huge play. You go from first and goal for the Warriors, then a flag causes them to have to re-punt, and then it's a low snap and it's a fumble, and then he gets brought down. So we'll see what Glenbard North does with this.
We'll see what Rady can do on this play.
Yeah, absolutely. Look for big gains from Tyreek Henderson and Josh Flowers, too. That's their number one and two wide receivers out there. Running game hasn't been that strong, but maybe Quentin Terry can prove us wrong here.
And Rady in the pocket. He hands it off, and he's going to gain some yardage there. And what a great run up the middle.
Yeah, by Quentin Terry. Looks like that was about a 9-yard gain, Ryan.
Yeah, about something like that.
Just short of the first down.
Second and 9 here on the 11.
Closest Glenbard North's been to the end zone all game.
Yeah.
All game.
Excuse me on that last play. It's second and 1. He's close to the touchdown. That's going to be a first and goal.
Marked down at the 1, I believe. Good run by Quentin Terry. Best two runs of the game on back-to-back plays. This is huge for the Panthers here. You can hear their fans getting very, very excited. Huge play for the Warriors defense.
Here's Rady in the pocket. Rady hands it off. And they're in. Touchdown, Glenbard North Panthers. And that will be 21-6.
You know, really a well put together drive after that huge play and the huge flag on the punt. Really impressive from Quentin Terry. Just three really solid runs. Would not go down, refused to go down, punches it in, and now we have a good ball game on our hands.
Now we got Aurelia Caruli here to kick the ball. And it's good. 21-7, Warriors lead, and we'll be right back after this. And we're back here from Dick Kerner Stadium.
Glenbard North about to kick it off. Huge score for them. Two possession game here. Let's see, this is really the first time that we've had to see special teams return for the Warriors. Got Bryce Logan and Nate Ashford in the backfield. Bryce Logan was huge on special teams last game. Let's see if he can make another difference tonight.
Kick is underway. It's a short kick. Oh. And he just has the ball. Oh, no. Lombard North recovers the fumble on the play. And it'll be first down for the Lombard North Panthers.
Here we go, Ryan. This could be huge. Glenbard, if they score on this play, could get it to a one-possession game before the end of the third quarter, where they were down by three possessions at the end of the half. Crazy turn of events here at Dick Koerner Stadium. Bet you're going to see quite a few carries from Quinton Terry after that last drive.
Yeah.
Let's see how the Warriors' defense responds. They can't be too happy with the past few events, so a couple players to watch here: cornerback Derek Lee, middle linebacker Kyle Schrader, and defensive end Zach Lyons.
Oh, a handoff, but they hit each other, and he's down.
A little miscommunication there. Lee Rady runs into Quinton Terry. That'll help the Warriors out a little bit.
And the Panthers are in the huddle to discuss the next play.
Well, Bonzi trying to slow play down a little bit.
And that's going to be second and 14 here on the 30-yard line. Let's see what Glenbrook North can do here. And the helmet goes flying on that play. Flowers with no gain there. It's going to be third and 14 here on the 30-yard line. What do you think, Dane, on that play?
I'm a little impressed with the Wabonzi response for defense. They've been really playing tight coverage, good man-on-man coverage.
Thank you.
Third and 14 for Glenbard North here. Wouldn't be surprised if they went for it on a fourth down play, too. Huge play in this game.
Here's Rady in the backfield. He throws it, and it's caught.
Another big catch for Tyreek Henderson for the first down.
First down for the Panthers.
Two really big plays. I mean, you're seeing a lot of big plays from the two top receivers on Glenbard North, Tyreek Henderson and Josh Flowers. Correction on that fourth down, my apologies. Fourth and 8.
Here's Rady throwing it. Oh, and it's incomplete, and they did not get the fourth down. It's going to be the Warriors' ball on the 24-yard line.
Rolling out, it looks like Derek Lee with the tip. Another big play by him. He intercepted the ball earlier, right before half. That score might have been huge for Wabonzi if they could have got that ball in, but time just ran out on them before the half ended. So we'll see how this game ends and if that ends up being an influential play, just like that flag on the punt by the Warriors.
Here's Westwood, handing off, and a gain about 2 from Nate Ashwood. You know, the running game in this game has been really good by the Warriors. I mean, they've had some very nice opportunities here in this game.
Right. I think the run's actually been more successful when they bounced it outside, though. I think that they keep running it up the middle, and Glenbard North's D-line's actually been catching up to it pretty well. Looks like there's an entry on the field right now. Number 9, Michael Wellman. Hope the best for him. Hope he feels better, and maybe we can see him on the field later today. But best wishes to him, and hopefully he can be okay. We're going to take a quick break right here. We'll be right back. And we're back. Injury update on the field. Michael Wellman got off the field under his own power. We always like to see that. Hopefully the best for him, and we see him back in the game as soon as possible. Back to the game, though. Tanner Westwood under center with a two-back set.
There's Westwood in the pocket. Fake handoff. He throws it deep. He's going deep. Oh, just short.
Believe Harper Cole is looking for a flag on that play. Believes he was interfered with. Ball was just a little bit overthrown. Still a pretty good throw by Tanner Westwood, flashing his arm right there. Maybe makes Glenbard North a little wary that this kid can throw the ball.
Westwood, looking for an opening. He passes it. And a loss of yardage.
Evan
That's
going to
be 4th and 10 and 24 in the ball on the 24-yard line.
Evan Williams with a huge tackle on the halfback screen to Nate Ashford. Couldn't really find any room to run. Pass was a little high, came down with the ball, and had nowhere to go. Evan Williams looming right over him.
And the Warriors are bringing out the punting unit here. Let's see what will happen this time. Henderson in the backfield. Waiting to receive the punt. And it's low.
A little short. Looks like Henderson's going to avoid picking it up. And it'll be 1st and 10 for Glenbard North at about the 31.
That wasn't a bad punt. It was decently good.
Yeah, it took a really good roll for the Warriors there. That's what you like to see, too. Not too bad field positioning.
Hands it off. Oh, and a jump.
Nice hurdle by Angelo Cusimano. Looks to be brought down by Avante Rogers.
Thank you. And Rady, in the pocket, fake handoff. He throws it, and it's an incomplete pass.
That looked to be off his back foot, Ryan. What'd you see?
Yeah, I saw that too. But it's going to bring up 3rd and 7 on the 34.
Very sure Glenbard North would like to score before the end of the third quarter. Make this a one-possession game going into the fourth quarter. Xavier Lee checks out, as well as Quinton Terry. Lee Rady back from the sideline. Now a timeout is called by Glenbard North. We will be right back. And we are back as Glenbard North's offense takes the field.
And the Glenbard North Panthers are on offense here. Let's see what Rady can do here. Oh, and that's going to be an offsides on the Warriors.
Carson O'Donnell looks like he jumped there.
And that's going to gain the Panthers about 4 yards.
Warriors pleading their case that someone moved on the Glenbard North offensive line. Does not look like it will go their way, though. And it will indeed go Glenbard North's way.
They're in the pocket. I mean, Rady's had a decent game here. There goes, oh, and he's hit hard. Hopefully he's okay. And he's okay.
He gets up, seems to be okay, but a wonderful hit by Chuck Robinson. Really popped him. It looked like a clean shoulder-to-shoulder hit. Chuck is a nickname for Charles Robinson, once again. The NIU tight end commit, one of the best, if not the best, tight end in the state of Illinois. Also makes a huge impact for the Warriors on defense, playing linebacker. Glenbard North punted. It didn't seem like the Warriors had anyone back receiving, though. Looked like the ball almost went off Derek Lee. Put his hands on his head. I actually thought it went off him. Warriors might have gotten away with one. Warriors offense takes the field.
We're here, and let's see what the offense is going to do. There's Westwood, and the snap to Westwood. Westwood looking deep. He's throwing it. Oh, halting on Glenbard North.
He was holding them all the way down there. Very surprised the flag didn't come out earlier. You see the young new wide receiver for the Warriors with Eric Esch going down. You get to see a lot more from Julian Kane, who has made an impact on the field today, making one of the first catches and making the huge play there. I wonder if they're going to call holding or pass interference. I expect it to be holding because the ball was uncatchable, though. 50 seconds left in the third quarter, 21-7, Wabanzi Warriors. Really a good throw by Tanner Westwood, especially off the back foot. He got a lot on that.
Yeah, I'd say so. Westwood hands it off. He's going in a gain about 8.
Nate Ashford tackled by Josh Flowers. Nate Ashford with a pretty good carry, probably his second best of the game, 8-yard gain. This Warriors offensive line been pretty good this game. Doesn't get talked about a lot, but definitely been doing their job today. Two back set for the Warriors.
Westwood doesn't hand it off. He gets the first down. What a great play. And that's the end of the third quarter. And we'll be right back after this break. And we're back here from the break. Warriors still with the ball. First down and 10 at the 48-yard line. And here's Westwood in the back of the field. He throws it. Almost picked off by the Panthers. But luckily, the ball hit the ground.
Jabari Fitzpatrick with the last touch of the ball, probably regretting not being able to intercept that. Looked like there was some miscommunication with his teammate, where both of them went for the ball, neither one came down with it. Would have been a really big play for the Panthers, but Wabanzi gets to keep the ball with second and 10 with 11:56 left in the fourth quarter.
We got Westwood out there. And for running back, we got Bryce Logan. Oh!
Great play by Tanner Westwood to get rid of that ball. Really turned nothing into nothing, but it could have been a lot worse.
Yeah, and you just got to get rid of those balls. I mean.
Yeah, absolutely. Especially, he went back about 5 yards to make sure he could plant his feet, get rid of the ball. But honestly, could have been a lot worse than it actually was.
It's better to throw it away than get it picked off, and Panthers could score. You never know.
Yeah, absolutely. Third and 10, it'll be interesting to see who the Warriors look to get this first down. My guess would be number 8, Chuck Robinson.
And Westwood looking deep, and it's picked off by the Panthers. And it's going to be the Panthers' ball at the 45-yard line, first and 10.
I believe that was picked off by Anthony Mayer. It almost looked like that ball either A, slipped out of Tanner Westwood's hands, or it was a miscommunication on a route running by one of his wide receivers. But either way, it is Glenbard North's ball, and it's only a two-possession game. So this drive is huge for the Panthers.
Oh, and he's going in the 50. And he's, oh, and he's still on his feet. He's going, and he's down at like the 25. But there's a flag on the play and a little
skirmish, if I'm not mistaken.
Yeah.
Quinton Terry with another big run. Wonder who the flag's gonna be on. Believe it might be an unsportsmanlike on either team. I wouldn't be surprised with either after that little skirmish. I don't think it was a hold on the play, which would bring that back. At most, it's going to be a 5 or 10 yard loss for either team. Let's see who it is, though. No call has been made on the field yet.
And the flag is going to be on the Warriors, a personal foul. And he hands it off. And he's down. Only a gain about a yard, if even that. And the tackle was made by number 38, Carson O'Donnell.
Student section still very loud for the Warriors. Attendance is still great. Warriors wearing their alternate uniforms tonight. They look very good. Brand new uniforms this year, especially the alternates, looking very sharp.
Here he is in the pocket. He throws it. And
intercepted.
It's intercepted.
Is that Derek Lee again? I believe so. Derek Lee with his second interception of the night. He's already making a difference for this Warriors team. That is two interceptions in one game, and also showing that he is a huge playmaker without that brace on his arm, saying, hey, I could have made a lot more interceptions last year, so I'm making up for it this year.
It's going to be a first and 10 for the Warriors at the 4-yard line here.
Going to have to be really smart here to avoid a safety.
I mean, I say you do a run right up the middle here. That's the safest play you can do here.
Absolutely. Protect that two-possession lead.
Ends it off. And he gains about a half a yard.
Bryce Logan bounces it outside. Can't pick up much on it, but something you'd like to see. They haven't bounced the ball outside that much today. Seems like when they have, too, they've gotten big carries, so maybe they're going to try doing that some more.
Westwood in the pocket. He hands it off.
Another run by Bryce Logan. That'll bring up third down. Oh, my apologies. That will be a first down. That will move the chains.
And the ball will be at the 15-yard line.
Looks like the Warriors are trying to run a little clock here as well. Really smart of them. Just trying to get this game over with. They started really strong. Kind of
slowed down. 9 seconds left on the play clock.
They're going to take this off quick.
Six, five, four, three, two,
They got
and they just got it off. Here's Bryce Logan up the middle. He's going. Oh, and he's tripped. I mean, my apologies. Nate Efron.
Nate Ashford with another big carry. That dual running threat of Bryce Logan and Nate Ashford, Glenbard North has not been able to keep up with, and the Warriors have not shown signs of slowing down this run game.
Oh, and a pitch, and that was very dangerous there.
Looks like a read option with a little bit of a miscommunication there. Maybe probably Tanner Westwood should have just tucked that and took the sack there. But either way, no damage done. They'll live to fight another play. One man in the backfield.
There's Chuck Robinson right there, number 8. He's running. Oh, and he gets hit hard. And that's going to be third down on the play.
...15 yards to pick up here for the Warriors. Be interesting to see what they do here. Honestly, to keep the clock running, you might want to just see a draw play here, see if you can catch Glenbard North sleeping, and keep the clock running. That'd be the smartest play to do. Just a reminder, too, Waubonsie Warriors have 3 timeouts, while the Glenbard North Panthers have 2.
It's 3rd and 15 on the 28. Are they going to get it off in time? 3-2? Yeah, and they just did. Here's Westwood to the third. Oh, and he drops it, and it's an incomplete pass. And here comes the punting unit.
Tanner Westwood there looking for Julian Kane. Julian Kane cannot come down with the ball. If he did, it would have been a phenomenal catch with a man all over him. Sadly, it looks like he just lost it as he was coming to the ground, and you have to complete that catch to the ground. Luckily, though, he did not make a runner's move, or else that would have been a fumble. Cross Holmes ready to kick.
We got Tyrek Henderson in the backfield.
Nice punt for a pretty high snap. Kyle Schrader picks it up.
Thanks. And we're here. Brady in the back, in the pocket, gives it to
PA announcer has been saying that actually number 33 for Glenbard North, his last name is Fitzpatrick. Our rosters seem to be mistaken. We have Quinton Terry, so we'll just scratch every time that I've said Quinton Terry, and we'll go with Fitzpatrick for now on at tailback, and he is in the position right now.
Oh, and he gains about 5 yards on the play. It'll be about 3rd and 7 on the 45-yard line. And the play clock is started. It's at 20 right now and going down. ...8 seconds left on the play clock. 5, and he hands it off. He does a pitch. Oh, and he's hit hard.
Fitzpatrick brought down by number 25, Brandon Guido. Looks like before the play even started, Ryan, that the Warriors were looking for some, that there was some movement on the offensive line. Did you see that?
Yeah, I saw a little bit of movement out there on the play. It's going to bring a fourth down.
Looks like the offense is staying on the field for the Panthers.
There's 5:40 left in the fourth quarter here. So let's see what the Panthers can do here. And Rady in the backfield throws it, and it's picked off.
Intercepted by
Nick Lamassol.
And that is the third interception of the night for the Waubonsie Warriors. They take the ball right back. Waubonsie DBs have been having themselves a night. Three interceptions, two from Derek Lee, one from Nick Lamoso.
There's Westwood handing it off, and he's going to get in about a couple yards. Good job there by Bryce.
Looks like the Warriors are going with a little bit of a conservative approach at this point with a two-score lead. Not really trying to put points on the board, but trying to run clock out at this point. Looks like they're just going to be really concerned.
And the Warriors have three. Here's Westwood in the pocket. He hands it off to Logan, and he is down around the 45-yard line, gains about 2 yards.
Tackled by Evan Williams. It looks like that the Panthers are going to start run committing here. Have to wonder if the Warriors will just run the ball with 4 minutes left in the game, especially with the Panthers having to be conservative with their timeouts. Be interesting to see what Tanner Westwood and the Waubonsie Warriors do.
Westwood in the pocket. He's going to throw it on this play. Oh, and it's incomplete. And that's going to bring up fourth down.
A little bit risky of a play call there.
Excuse me on that.
You're very excused. A little bit of risky play there, especially passing the ball with 3 minutes left in the game, 4 minutes left in the game. Scratch that. Now the Panthers get a stoppage on the clock, and they get the ball back. If they score here, do you imagine that they go for an onside kick here, Ryan?
I would imagine they would. I mean, they need two touchdowns this game. And there's a flag on the play.
Offside here would bring up fourth and one for the Warriors. I think it is going to be on them for a false start. We'll have to wait and see. Are too many men on the field? It looks like Tyreek Henderson's counting how many people are on the field right now. I believe it's going to be a too many men on the field for the Panthers, so I think that'll bring up fourth and one for the Warriors. Interesting to see if they go for it.
It's going to be fourth and one for the Warriors.
Warriors take a timeout, too. It looks like they might go for it.
Yeah, we'll see here. I mean,
I would almost just stack the line and let Westwood jump over it, see if he can get that first down. He's a lengthy quarterback. And he's a talented runner. I believe he could get through. Maybe even just give it to Bryce Logan. They have two downhill runners. I honestly think that it would be in their best interest to go for it and try and put this game away. But
and
then
our upcoming schedule here for the Warriors is next week, the 8th at Neuqua Valley, and then the 15th, we're Central, and then the 22nd, Matea Valley. At 7:30, every game is this year.
Three big rivalry games for the Warriors coming up, especially against Neuqua. Sadly, can no longer be called the War of 204. But then again, some of the students here still call it that, which is totally okay. Two back set.
Westwood here. Oh, and there's a flag on the play.
Looks like Alex Lemons went off sides for the Warriors. Now the punting unit's going to come out. Sadly, might have ruined a play that could have been huge for the Warriors. Let's see if Glenbard North can capitalize on this mistake. Tyreek Henderson goes back to receive the punt.
And the punt is underway. It's kicked off.
That's a boomer. And it's muffed.
And it's out of play.
Kyle Schrader would have been the first one to get there. Sadly, the ball did go out of bounds. So Glenbard North is saved and still has life. Tyreek Henderson not happy with himself after that one. Luckily, they keep the ball. And let's see what they can do with it. It's gotten a little chilly outside tonight. Luckily, the fans are staying, though.
Yep.
About 50 degrees at the moment. Players don't seem to be affected by it.
And here comes Rady in the backfield. He's running it, and he's going to run it himself.
Fumbled it at the last second,
Fumbled it, but it went out of bounds.
For the second play in a row.
So it'll be second down in 10 at the 17-23-yard line.
Looks like they changed that to second and 4, actually. Not much time on the clock for the Panthers. Luckily, that ball did go out of bounds for them.
Oh, and it's incomplete.
Underthrown by Rady. We'll have to see, too. I almost guarantee you that the Panthers will go for it on fourth down. What do you expect to see here?
Yeah, I think they'll go for it. I mean, they got to do it. And if they don't get it, they're going to have to go for the onside kick. They're going to have to go for it. My apologies.
Yeah, we understand it. Especially if they score, you know they will have to go for the onside kick. There is no time left, especially with two timeouts. They're probably going to have to use them on this drive. Wouldn't you imagine so?
Yeah. Let's see what they can do here. Rady. Rady throwing it, and it's caught for a first down.
Once again to Josh Flowers, really been a difference maker for this Glenbard North offense. Really only two receivers active here. It's really been Tyreek Henderson and Josh Flowers picking up the slack here. And then there's been Lee Rady that's been making the on-target throws for them. And really, they haven't gotten their tight ends involved at all. It's really just been runs or it's been throws to those two wide receivers.
I mean, Rady's had a pretty good game here. Rady throwing it deep. Oh, and it's incomplete. That will bring up third down.
I believe that was...
My apologies, second down.
I believe that was Derek Lee on the coverage. I believe he got a hand on that at the last second, or Tyreek Henderson had the ball, would have had the ball fall right into his hands. Good play by the DB of Wabonzi, who's had a monstrous game. He's something going on with him right now.
He's fixing his gloves, I think that was.
Gloves or mouth guard, one of the two.
One of the two. Tyreek Henderson had been a great game.
Absolutely. He's had about 6 receptions for 70 yards.
Oh, and down he goes. Sacked by number 47.
Elijah Priavolos. I believe Avante Rogers got there at the last second as well. Helped him bring him down.
Third and 18 at the 25-yard line.
Huge loss for the Panthers. Clock's still running.
Third and 18 to go. 18 yards to go.
Time is not on the Panthers' side right now. They're really going to have to get this ball moving. going to have to make some big pass plays.
2:22 left in the fourth quarter. Here comes Rady. Rady throwing it, and no one was there. The pass was intended for number two.
Josh Flowers.
Josh Flowers.
Derek Lee on the coverage once again.
And that's going to be fourth down and 18.
You have to believe the game is on this play right here, wouldn't you guys say, Ryan?
Yeah, I would say the game is on the line right now. If they don't get this, I'm afraid to say that it might not be easy to come back. And Rady back. He's going to run it? Okay. And that's going to be a turnover on downs, and it's going to be the Warriors' ball.
Let me ask you this, Ryan. What would you do on that play? Because you almost have to think that, is it worth it to just chuck it up?
And you know, at that point, I would have just threw it deep and hoped for the best. Because running it, not as good of luck to get 18 yards.
Right. 18 yards is really tough on a run. Maybe if it's 10, maybe you go for the run. But I'm thinking, like, you have Tyreek Henderson and Josh Flowers, who have both had phenomenal games, and they're two quick wide receivers. See, chuck it up, throw it in the air, and see if they can run under it. Worst case scenario, gets picked off, but if you think about it, it's the same. It's probably better field positioning for your defense than it is right now.
Yeah, correct. I totally agree on that one. Where's...
And we'll be right back. And we're back.
Westwood in the backfield. He receives the ball. And gain about 3 on the play. Looks like they're letting the clock run out.
They're going to wait till the last second to snap this one off.
Yeah. Now, what do you think? Do you knee it on this play, or do you run another play?
I would go for the knee. I'd be conservative, but it looks like they're about to run it.
Yeah. Hands it up to Bryce Logan. For a gain, about 3 yards. It's going to be 3rd and 7, and only 41 seconds left in this ball game.
Kind of surprised the Panthers haven't used their timeouts yet.
I'm very surprised on that one, too.
You think they're throwing in the towel?
Yeah.
I'd imagine so at this point.
Fortunately.
Panthers had a very good game, though, very respectable. It looks like time is not on their side, and they're probably going to run out. Still some time left. Really, really entertaining game, though, I'd have to say, Ryan.
Yeah, I'd have to say, too. Glenbard North, they tried their best out there, and it just didn't happen tonight. And that's probably going to be the game.
They're going to let
Warriors win 21-7. And here's the handshake. And, I mean, they had an incredible game, these two teams. The Warriors won 21-7. Thank you, and have a great night.
I'm Dane Dreyfus.
And I'm Ryan Carlin.
And this was a Wabanzi Valley Television production. Thank you.